say, Snuffy, you know what? I'll bet today will be a perfect day for my friends to finally meet you. What do you think?
Sounds fine, Bert.
Oh, look. Oh. Hi.
Oh, hello there.
So what do you think? Maybe I'll have one of my friends come here and finally see you?
Sounds good to me, Bert.
Okay, I'm going to go bring somebody back here, so don't go away.
I won't.
Don't leave this time, please. Huh?
Okay, I'll wait.
Okay,
right
I'll be right
here.
Back. This sign says no gee, I can't even read that. Boy, that's a hard sign to read. Well, I wonder who's around. Must be, oh boy, there's David and Olivia. Hey, David, Olivia. Hey, you gotta come to my nest right away because Snuffy's there right now and he wants to meet you.
Big Bird, we can't. We gotta go vote.
Yeah.
Oh, does that have something to do with this sign I've been seeing around?
Yes, see, today is election day. And today is the day when everybody votes for who they want to run the country, okay, or the state, or the city. Come on.
And Big Bird, it is very important that everybody vote.
But how do you vote?
Well, why don't you come in and see?
Oh, okay.
Yeah, come on.
Okay, come on, Big Bird.
Hi.
Hi, Judy.
Hi, Judy.
Hi.
We brought Big Bird along with us because he wants to learn about voting. So
yeah.
Could we take a look at one of the voting booths?
Sure, go ahead.
Okay, yeah. Great, thanks.
Okay, officer.
Thank you.
Okay. Go ahead. Oh, look. Look, somebody's voting.
Someone's voting.
Oh.
I sure did. Yeah. Yeah. I gotta get to work now though.
Okay.
I'll see you later.
Bye-bye.
All right, Big Bird, take a look at this.
Wow.
Okay, now, this is a voting booth.
Well, those are all names up and down.
Inside here are the names of all the people who want to get elected, and these are the offices. So, you pick a person, and then you press there, and you voted.
You mean you just, if you want to vote for mayor, you just pick the one you want, and you
pick
push
one
the
of the guys that you want, or the ladies, and you
and
go,
then it's
boom.
Voted.
And it's voted.
It's good, huh?
But what's the curtain for?
Oh, well, the curtain is so nobody will see who you voted for. Because, you see, it's a secret.
A secret?
Oh, yeah.
Wow.
And then when all the votes are added up, the person with the most votes wins.
Gee, I wonder if Snuffy knows that. Oh, no, Snuffy.
Snuffy?
Oh, I forgot. You know, he's at my nest and he's waiting to meet you. Well, I could go get him and then he can meet you and learn all about voting, too. Oh, great. I'll be back. Excuse me.
An imaginary friend wants to learn about voting?
Well.
Oh, you're still here, Snuffy. That's good, but because you gotta come with me, see? Because David's down at the voting place and Olivia's there too, and she's voting right now.
Voting?
Yes, it's very important, Snuffy. I'll tell you all about it. Come on.
Okay, Bert.
This is the place, Snuff.
Officer, could you come here?
What's the problem?
I can't find my bench file.
Right in here, Snuffy. This is where people vote, and this is a voting booth. Somebody's in there. Maybe it's Olivia. Is that you, Olivia?
No, it's me, David. Big Bridge, go away, I'm voting.
But Mr. Snuffleupagus is here now. Why don't you come out and you can meet him, okay?
Big Bird, I'm voting now.
Well, that's okay. We want to vote, too.
You can't vote, Big Bird.
But why not? You said it was important for everyone to vote.
Yes, it is, but you have to be 18 and registered.
Well, I know what 18 is, David, but I don't know what registered is. Do you, Snuffy?
Look,
when you're 18 years old, you have to go sign up with the Board of Elections. And then you tell them your name and where you live and how old you are. And then you have to prove whether or not you are a citizen, and then they let you vote. Now, please, let me finish my voting, okay?
David, when I'm 18, the first thing I'm going to do is ask you to repeat all that, okay? That way I can vote. Right, Snuffy?
Right. You know, Bert, I wonder if my mommy knows that she's supposed to vote today. She's over 18. I better go home and remind her.
Oh, no, Snuffy, but if you leave, David won't be able to see you when he comes out.
Oh, I know, Bert, but I think it's more important that my mommy vote.
But, gee.
Oh, I heard a strange voice, Big Bird.
Oh, that was Snuffy.
Oh, yeah, huh? But he's not here now, is he?
Well, he was here.
Oh.
But he just left to make sure his mommy knows to vote today. I'm sorry, David, but he says that's more important than meeting you.
His mommy.
Yeah.
Well, let me tell you something else about voting, Big Bird.
What?
Well, I mean, something other than having to be 18 and registered.
Oh, what else?
You also have to be real.
Wait a minute, that's very funny, very funny. Wait a minute, David. You know, you're just upset because he didn't...
How are you?
Not too well. I seem to have misplaced my J.
Well, maybe you left it in the car.
I doubt it.
I do that sometimes.
I don't have a car.
Misplaced your J, you say?
I did say that, yes. Well,
did you look under your hat?
How silly of me. Of course, this is the letter J.
Well, I know a friend who has one. See, his name is Jim.
Very good. The name Jim starts with the letter J.
Lots of names do, you
know. Do you know anyone else whose name starts with the letter J?
Well, no. Jim's the only guy I know.
I see.
Yeah, I live in a garage, and I don't get much of a chance to meet
him. Well, no matter. John starts with J.
I'd like to meet him sometime, maybe after the show, huh?
So does Joe and Jack and Jerry.
Yeah, that's very interesting.
There are lots more. There's Jasper and Jerome and Jonah and Jeb. And Jeffrey and Jamie and Jean and Job and Jenny and...
Hold on momentarily.
Yes?
Do only names start with the letter J?
Oh, no. Lots of regular words do, too. There's jump, jerk, jam, jib, jigger, jab, jobber, jut, jet, jot, junk, juxtaposition.
Well, keep them under your hat.
There goes a wonderful person.
Wanna dance?
Perhaps later.
Get up and dance.
Thank you.
it's the letter J. So, letter J goes J. Here he comes! What's that? Oin, oin. Oin. Join. There they go. Join. Look at that big ump. Ump! It's blocking the track. Ump. I know. Jump! Jet. Now he's junk.
This is hopeless!
We're never gonna finish these dishes!
Are you?
I am Captain Cooperation.
Do you always talk that way?
What way?
What are you doing in our kitchen?
I am here to make that dishwashing job a lot easier.
Just as I thought.
Trying to sell us soap, eh, Captain? Well, we don't need any.
I'm not trying to sell you soap. I'm going to sell you cooperation. With a little cooperation, that job will be done in no time.
Sounds expensive.
Very.
Cooperation doesn't cost you anything.
Maybe if we try this cooperation stuff, he'll go away.
How does it work?
How does it work? You wash and you dry. Or is it? You dry and you wash. You wash and you dry. Just look at cooperation go to work on those dirty dishes.
Cooperation stuff really works!
Well, Captain, I guess you'll be leaving now, won't you, eh?
Not quite yet.
Why not?
You are standing on my cape.
No, Captain. You're standing on your cape.
Thank you.
officer has some instructions as to how to use the voting machines. Would anybody here like a copy?
Here we are, Mrs. Snuffleupagus, and this is the voting machine. You know, I could go give your registration ticket in for you, your card.
Oh, that would be very kind.
Okay,
Mr. Bird.
Let's see. I guess the lady's over here. Oh, excuse me. Are you the lady with the registration? I have the registration ticket for Mrs. Snuffleupagus. She's here to vote.
Oh, yes. It seems to be in order. Fine.
She can vote?
Let her vote.
Swell.
Terrific.
Hmm. Gee. Look at that. The voting booth curtain doesn't completely cover Mrs. Snuffleupagus. Hmm. Gee. I can see at least half of her. All her brown, shaggy fur. And her long, shaggy tail. And her hind legs and her 2 feet. Wow. Hey. And if I can see her, then so can everybody else. Oh, boy. This is really great.
Yeah, little stuff, you know. So I don't mind that.
Oh, come quick, because Snuffy's mommy is voting, and you can see her, or at least half of her.
Half of her, Big Bird?
Uh-huh.
Which half?
Ha, ha, ha. The back half, of course. Half of her sticks out from under the curtain, and you can see her brown fur, her long, shaggy tail, and her 2 back feet and legs.
You know, this Big Bird is something. Let me tell you.
I mean,
what an imagination.
I'm telling you.
I didn't imagine anything.
Okay.
Well, I certainly hope this Snuffleupagus wins.
But you gotta come now. She won't be there forever. Please.
Big Bird, look, I can't leave the store.
Oh, please, please, please. Olivia, you can come. It's a perfect opportunity.
Oh. Okay, Big Bird, I'll come.
Oh, boy, come
I'll
on.
Let you know.
Hurry, hurry, Olivia. Now tell me what you see.
Well, I see 2 legs with brown jeans on them and 2 feet with cowboy boots on them.
What? But she was here.
Big Bird, there's no brown shaggy fur here. You know what I think? I think you saw these 2 brown legs and imagined...
No, she was here, I know.
Excuse me.
J. I was named after the letter J because everything my family does starts with a J.
There are folks who poke fun at the way my family's run. It's a joking, joyful, jumping jamboree. So if you'd like a job, just join our jolly mob and we'll show you how much fun a J can be. My sister's into judo. My father likes to jog. My mother washes jelly jars. My uncle jumps a log. Big brother flies a jet plane. My nephew drives a jeep. Junior is a jitterbug. And grandma juggles sheep. My niece plays in a jazz band. My granddad Jimmy's Doors. My cousin runs a jackal farm. My auntie judges boards. Great uncle raises John Quills. Great granddad plays with jacks. My wife became a journeyman. And me, well, I just stay out of their way. Jay.
And now it's time to play everybody's favorite game, Name That Sound. And here's everybody's favorite game show host, Guy Smiley.
Thank you. This is Guy Smiley, America's favorite game show host, and we're here to play Name That Sound. So let us welcome our first contestant. Would you step in, please? Welcome. I understand you're Mr. Honker from the land of honk. Yes, and you certainly have a lot of friends out there, don't you? Okay, now, Mr. Honker, do you know how to play our game? Well, let me explain it to you then. You see, we are going to play three sounds. That's three sounds. And if Mr. Honker can name what makes each of those sounds, you will be very, very happy and proud of yourself, all right? Okay, now, are you ready for your first sound? Okay, now here it is. Listen carefully and see if you can name this sound. All right. Yes, Mr. Honker, do you think you know what makes that sound? Okay, well, what makes that sound? I can't understand him. I can't understand you, Mr. Honker. Oh, dear, well, I guess he just gave up. Yes, that's very sad, isn't it, ladies and gentlemen? Oh, well, no, what's this?
What are you doing? I was in the middle of a voice lesson.
Oh, I get it, I get it. You have brought in a cow. He's brought in a cow, and that's the correct answer. Very good, very good.
Television camera. What? And your guy Smiley!
I am, well, yes.
This is a television studio! On television!
Well, you are.
What do you want me to do?
Nothing.
Sing, dance, I can
over.
Do anything, you know.
No, if
I
you
can
would
do just,
just
about
Mr. Honker,
anything.
If you would just get rid of this cow, please. Yes, are you all right, cow?
Yes.
Oh, good. Well, now, are you ready for your second sound? Okay, well, listen closely and see if you can name this sound. There it is. Do you know what makes that sound? Okay, well, what makes that sound? I still can't understand him. Yes? Well, you only have a few seconds. Only a few seconds and what? Oh, I see.
What's going on here?
Yes, you have brought in a horse, and a horse is the correct answer. Very good. A horse is what makes that sound.
I make that sound?
No, forgetful. You're not a horse.
I'm not.
No, I am.
No, yeah, I forgot, you see. I didn't remember.
Okay,
who
very
I was.
Good. If you'll just get these people out of here, we'll continue with the game. All right, now, Mr. Honker, you have gotten two right. Let's see if you can name this last sound. Yes? Yes? Do you think you know what makes that sound? Well, perhaps in this case you should just write it down. What? Oh, no. I'm afraid he may have the right answer. Yes? Oh, no. Oh, my goodness. My goodness. He did it. It is a fire engine. That is the correct answer. So you win, Mr. Hopper.
Is that a fire engine I heard? Is that a fire?
No, there's no fire. Step out of the way here.
If I'm not a horse, what am I?
This is Guy Smiley saying that's our show for today. May all your sounds be happy ones. Can we now just get this fire engine here? And can someone clear away the livestock?
No.
Say.
Someone who says five's too much should get a job playing basketball. Who says five's not a real great time? We think five is quite sublime. See us walk and hear us talk. We most emphatically gotta squawk about being and feeling alive. And five.
What do you do with a pet? You hug him, but don't slug him. You squeeze him, but don't tease him. You love him, but don't shove him. You give him water to drink, sometimes a bath in the sink. You give him food to eat, and sometimes a treat. You walk with him, and you talk with him. Run with him, have fun with him. But what do you always do with a pet? You pet him.
Hey, Malcolm, what do you say? Should we take a walk in the woods, an imaginary walk in the woods?
Okay, great, great.
Okay, you start.
All right, we're walking through the forest, and I feel a very soft breeze blowing. Oh, I see a bird over there, Mr. Galway. Yeah? Ooh, and there's an owl. And up there, I see a whippoorwill. Ooh. And I hear water. I hear water running, and it's a running brook. And there's a rabbit. There's a rabbit coming to the brook. And the rabbit jumps over the brook. I felt a drop. Oh, I felt another drop. It's beginning to rain. It's beginning to rain harder, Mr. Galway. Harder and harder. Oh, it's coming down, cats and dogs. Oh, oh, and it's lightning. Oh. It's letting up. The storm's letting up. And it's just raining a little bit. And it's just drops. And it stopped raining. And the sun came out. And we're in an open field. And over there, I see a shepherd with his sheep. That was a really nice walk, Mr. Galway.
Boy, did you like it?
Yeah. I'm sort of tired now.
Well, why don't I play you a nice lullaby?
Oh, okay.
Once upon a time, there was a five that was more than just a five. It was Jive Five. One, two, three, four, five.
All right.
One, two, three, four, five, five frogs.
All right.
One, two, three, four, five. Baby.
Hello there.
Hi.
Tracy and I are now going to talk to you about how about we talk about numbers. You want to talk about numbers? Today we're going to talk about the number five. And you know what the number five looks like?
Like a caterpillar.
Can you count up to five?
Yeah.
Yeah.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Wow, how about that?
Someone that I care for. Gee, the one I need is you. A chum who's always there for me. If skies are gray or blue, your precious little picture is a fixture in this frame. I love to sit and stare at it and softly spell your name. D means you're delightful and delicious and so dear. U says I'm undone by what you do. C is for the cute way that you squeak into my ear. K is for the kick I get from you. I'll be there if you're in hot water. E, you're extra special to the end. Put them all together, they spell ducky, rubber ducky. I'm so lucky you're my friend.
Oh, Rubber Ducky, that's a great picture of you. Yeah, you like the song?
You're delightful and delicious and so dear.
You
says I'm undone by what you do.
Ah,
is for the cute way that you squeak into my ear.
Hey.
For the kick I get from you.
Ah.
I'll be there if you're in hot water.
Hey.
You're extra special to the end.
Ah.
Put them all together, they spell
five.
You want a five?
Terrific, man. Yeah, that's good. Yeah, come on, that's right. Let's turn it around. Yeah, that's it. That's right.
Pretty good, huh?
both can't be it. Well, listen, that's because that's not how the game is played. That's why.
Hey, Oscar, what's going on? Some problem?
Hey, you swamp mushy muddy muddy. Of course there's a problem here. Yeah. Listen to that. Oh, now everybody's in on it.
In on what?
Well, the elephants are going to play tag, but both Fluffy and Wolfgang want to be it.
Oh, that's some big problem.
Well, it is, because I want them to hurry up and play. But there's nothing like a wonderful game of elephant tag.
Well, Oscar, why don't you just tell them who's going to be it?
Well, I couldn't do that. They like to decide these things for themselves.
Oh. Well, listen, since it's election day, why don't you have them vote on it?
Hey. Now, why didn't I think of that?
No, Oscar, I was just kidding. I was really only kidding.
Hey, this is nothing to kid about. Hey, that's a great idea. Okay, elephants, our problem solved. You're going to vote on who's going to be it.
Elephants voting?
All right, now, everybody close your eyes. That means you too, Sabrina. Yeah. All right, now, everybody who wants Fluffy to be it, raise your trunks.
Oh!
Wait. Let's see, how many...
Well, you gotta count them. Let me count them, okay? You ready?
Yeah.
This is six, seven, and eight.
Eight.
That's eight.
Okay. Eight for Fluffy. Put your trunks down now. Okay, now, pay attention. Now, everybody who wants Wolfgang to be it, raise your trunks. Okay. Doesn't look like everybody's voting down there. Uh-huh. Okay, now how many are
there? Okay, I'll count them. One, two, three, four.
Four. Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Okay, let's see now. Fluffy got eight votes.
Right, eight for Fluffy.
And Wolfgang's only got four.
Right.
Okay, put your trunks down. Fluffy, you're it. Now, don't be upset, Wolfgang. You'll get to be it some other time now. Will you play tag?
Oh.
Here they go.
Whoa.
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 Hey, look at that. Whoa.
Whoa. Whoa.
This is why I couldn't wait. My trash can's gonna be a mess.
Oh, another sign. Oh, boy. S-U-L-K. S-U-L-K. Ah, someone's mixed these letters again. There, I'll fix that. Okay. Now, ch-l-oos. Still mixed up. Okay, I'll fix them up there. There we go. S-k-ool. S-k-ool. School. Uh-oh. School!
Hey, what's the big idea? It's Saturday.
Oh, no school.
Oh, hello there. It is I, the Count. Yes, they call me the Count because I love to count things. Today I am going to tell you a story about when I was a very young little Count. Yes, I'm going to tell you about my first day at school.
The first day that I went to school, yes, I remember clearly. My mommy made me leave at home the spiders I loved dearly. I felt a little sad as I walked through the classroom door. But then I saw more children than I'd ever seen before. Ha ha! I cried, my new school will be fun. For I can count all of the children one by one. Yes, I'll count regularly.
Marietsu. That makes number one and two. I'll count Boris and Igor. That makes number three and four. Morris, Jane and Eloise. 5, 6, 7, if you please. Theodore and Adeline make number 8 and number 9. And then I will count Ben. For Ben is number 10. Yes, there's Gregory, Sue and Boris. Igor, Eloise and Morris. Theodore, Jane and Adeline and Ben. And that makes 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. The teacher taught the alphabet. We had to learn each letter. The alphabet was not much fun, but then things got much better. The teacher said, my children dear, it's time for numbers now. Can anybody count to 10? A small voice yelled, and how? Just watch, I cried, before this class is done. I will count all of the children one by one. Yes, I'll count Gregory and Sue. That makes number 1 and 2. I'll count Boris and Igor. That makes number 3 and 4. Morris, Jane and Eloise. 5, 6, 7, if you please. Theodore and Adeline make number 8 and number 9. And then I will count Ben. For Ben is number 10. Yes, there's Gregory, Sue and Boris. Igor, Eloise and Morris. Theodore, Jane and Adeline and Ben. And that makes 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. All right, everybody, all together now. There's Gregory, Sue, and Boris, Igor, Eloise, and Morris, Theodore, Jane, and Adeline, and Ben. And that makes 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Yes, ha-ha, but those are only just some of the children in the class. Next, I must count the rest of the children. Then I must count the children in all the other classes in the school. And then I will count all the children in all the schools everywhere. Ah, let me begin. There's Ermengarde, that's 11. There's Gerhard, it's 12. Renati is 13. Steve, 14. Bella, 15. Oh, I love it so much.
Fish.
Thank you.
You know, today is election day. Mm-hmm. And then everyone's voting. Do you know what that means? When you vote?
Yeah.
What does that mean?
It means that the people of the country elect the president, the governor, or the mayor.
That's right.
And they have this box, and it's full of numbers, and the one who has the highest number gets to be a president.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Well, in the box, there are names of the different people who want the jobs, and then people have to vote for those names, right? And then whoever gets the most votes is the one who gets the job.
Yep.
Right. Has anyone here ever voted for anything? Yeah, Jimmy, what have you voted for?
I voted for when I was 5 years old.
Mm-hmm.
I was voting.
Yeah.
And then.
Would you vote in school?
Yep.
For something?
Yeah.
What'd you vote for in school?
I voted for whoever could, you know, drive the boat a little bit.
When you were playing a game like driving a boat in school? Yeah. Well, did you ever vote for what kind of game you wanted to play in school? Yeah?
Yes. And I voted for a game in school. Mm-hmm. Whoever picks the best game that everyone likes wins the game, and I picked it.
So in other words, whichever game gets the most votes, or whoever wants to play the game, you know, I mean, if enough kids want to play the same game.
Enough already. Look, I vote you should all get lost, so beat it, scram.
Wait a minute, Oscar. Now, if you can vote, then the rest of us can vote in this thing, too. I mean, that's what voting is all about. You need more than one person to vote.
Who cares?
Well, I think we should all have a vote in this. Okay, all of those in favor of us getting lost, raise your hands.
I got my hand up.
Okay,
get lost.
That's one vote. All of us in favor of us staying here, raise your hands. Okay, that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 for staying put, Oscar.
Oh, so?
Looks like majority wins.
Oh, and that means that I'm a loser.
That's right.
Yeah, and grouches love to lose. So, whoopee, I lost! Yay, I lost! And I couldn't have done it without you kids.
Kermit the Frog with another fast-breaking news story.
Hi, all. This is Kermit the Frog, and with me today is the world-famous ballerina, Miss Suzanne Farrell. And Miss Farrell is going to do 20, what is it you're going to do?
Grand battement.
Yes, of course. 20 grand battement.
Hello, Kermit.
Hi, Grover.
Hi, Suzanne.
Hi, Grover.
What you going to do?
Well, Suzanne is going to do 20 grand battement.
Wow!
Would you like to show Grover what a grand battement is?
Yes.
Oh.
Woo! That was cute.
Isn't that neat?
Mm.
And you're going to do 20 of them, huh?
Sure.
Okay. Well, let's go. We'll count them.
One.
One.
Two.
Three.
Four.
Five.
Six.
Seven.
Eight.
Nine.
Wow.
10,
I'm getting dizzy.
11,
11
12,
13,
14,
15,
15,
16, can't you do it?
17,
yes, she's going to do it.
18,
18,
19, 20. 20. Wow, how about that, ladies and gentlemen?
Yes,
huh?
Yes.
That was just wonderful. Wonderful.
Look,
She even bows pretty.
In an old and far off place, there was a lowercase n. Lonely and cold, she would stare off into space, and it was known that she would cry now and then. Lowercase n, standing on a hill. The wind is very still for the lowercase n. Then one day a rocket ship came racing from the sky. It landed on the hill and it opened up a door. Then something started coming outside. A lowercase n.
She's not lonely anymore.
They are standing on the hill.
There are two that stand for sure.
The wind is very still for the lowercase n.
Hey, Ernie.
Yes, Bert.
Is there a draft here? I feel very cold.
Oh, you feel cold, Bert?
Yeah.
Oh, well, just a second, Bert. Wouldn't
what?
Want you feeling cold. I'll get something so that you won't feel cold any longer. Just a minute, Bert. Wait right there.
Oh. Oh, okay.
Here you go, Bert.
What? What's that?
This is a little shawl.
Yeah?
My grandmother left it here last time she was
Oh,
cold.
When she was visiting. This is your grandmother's shawl.
Now your shoulders won't feel cold anymore.
Oh, it's okay, very
Bert?
Nice.
Bert?
Thank you, Ernie.
Yeah.
Oh, where's my book now?
Here you go, Bert.
What?
Lean over a second.
What do you want?
This is earmuffs, so your ears won't be cold. Okay, Bert?
Oh, Ernie, the shawl's enough. I'm
there
not,
you go.
I'm not that... Hey, Ernie?
Bert.
What?
Here's something else you need.
What?
This is a hat. So your head won't be
Ernie,
cold.
I don't need
bend
a hat.
Over. Bend over, Bert.
Hey, leave me alone, Ernie. What are you doing? Ernie.
There we go.
Ernie.
There.
Where are you?
Can you see, Bert? Oh,
no.
Just a second. Let me fix it for you. Peek. Okay? How's that?
Fine.
Good, all right.
But I don't want it.
Well, what else do you
Ernie,
need, Bert?
I don't need anything else.
You need a coat. That's what you need, Bert.
I want my book so
a
I can
nice,
read.
A nice, warm,
Ernie,
fuzzy coat,
Ernie.
Bert. So that nothing,
Ernie,
no part of you will feel cold. Okay,
Ernie, you're
Bert?
Going bananas. I don't need this.
What else do you
I'm
need, Bert?
I'm trying to read. I don't need. I
you need
my,
a muffler, Bert.
I need some basic
that's what
quiet.
You need. A nice muffler,
Ernie,
so that your neck won't be cold either. Okay. How's that, Bert? How do you feel now, Bert? I can't hear you, Bert. I can't hear him. Oh, just a second here, Bert. How do you feel now, Bert?
I feel hot. I feel broiling hot.
Oh, you do? Well, just a second, Bert. Wait right there. I have just what you need.
Ernie, where'd you go? Ernie?
Here's what you need, Bert.
What are you doing?
This is an ice bag.
An ice bag?
Yeah, here. Hold on to it there, Bert.
Now
let me open
Ernie,
the window, Bert.
I don't need a window.
Here we go.
Ernie, leave me alone.
Okay.
Ernie,
now suppose I turn on the electric fan here, Bert.
No. I'm getting out of here.
Okay, Bert.
What are you
Come
doing?
On, Bert.
Ernie, what are you doing?
Come on, Bert.
I don't want
to.
I don't want
to. Okay, Bert.
Ah!
How's that, Bert? Feel better now, Bert?
Leave me alone.
Gosh, I have to hurry. Oh, hi. I'm the letter N. You see me all the time in words like nail, nest, and net. Why, I'm right up front of words like notebook, needle, and noodle. Don't forget other N words such as nuts, napkins, and nose. But most of all, don't make noise at night. The letter N is nice. I like it.
You know something, Snuffy?
What, Bert?
Well, everybody's voted for something today, even Oscar's elephants, but we haven't.
Oh, dear. You're right, Bert.
And I'd like to vote for something, wouldn't you?
Me too.
Oh, but it's time to say goodbye.
Oh, Bert, maybe we could vote on whether to say goodbye or not.
Oh, hey, that's a great idea.
Oh.
Okay, now ready? All those in favor of saying goodbye, raise your snuffle or your wing. Okay, let's count the vote. One, two. Okay. Now, those who do not want to say goodbye, raise your wing or your snuffle. Well, we have two votes that say we should say goodbye. We voted to say goodbye.
We sure did, Bert.
Then what are we waiting for? Bye. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Come again. See you on Sesame Street.
Bye-bye.
Oh, yes, and Sesame Street has been brought to you today by the letters J and N.
And by the number 5.
That's right. And Sesame Street is a production of...
The Children's Television Workshop. Oh, I'm sure glad we voted, Bird.
Me too, Snuffy. Everybody should vote.